Here.
Thanks, Mother. Thank you. What's wrong?
Are you sure it's okay with you that the both of them are here?
Mother, of course it's okay. I mean, even though I know that they're uncomfortable here, at least I know that they're doing it for me. But sometimes I wonder if I'm doing the right thing. I mean, look at them. They're both having a hard time just being here, but they're doing it for me. Am I being selfish?
Son, they love you very much, and you are the reason why they're here. And honestly, it's you that I'm worried about. You know that they were together before, and whatever it is that they're going through right now, you're bothered by it. Hey, I don't want you to get hurt.
Yes, I know. Of course, I don't want to get hurt too, Mother. And I know that it's a great sacrifice for them just to be here. It's because of this. It's because of this that I felt how much they really love me. I don't think there's anything they can do that could possibly hurt me. Because I love them both. And you know what? I'm sure that there's a really good reason why we're all here. And one thing's for sure. I'm very happy. Because I'm with you. All of you.
That is not true. What you're saying is not true. Camilo, what are you saying? What you're saying is not true. Huh?
What you're saying? What you're saying
is nothing but a lie.
Essing. Please get somebody Orlando back in the room. Go on, Orlando.
Got it.
Excuse me.
You know, I even went to the house of his brother, Joaquin. I didn't see her there. I think she left for good this time.
So what now? Does this mean you won't see her anymore?
I don't know, Rosie. But I'm really hoping that I can see her again. I wonder what happened to her. I hope she's in good hands, Rosie. You know, I don't know what I'll do to myself if ever something bad would happen to her.
A man positively identified as Joaquin Victorino plotted and attempted to murder businessman Camilo San Carlos. San Carlos is more popularly known as the boss.
Rosie, it's Joaquin. He's Kara's brother.
What did you say, Gian? Will you stop it, Rover? Will you stop it?
Why?
Stop it!
Come on.
That's
Come
enough.
Here.
Rover!
Come on.
Rover? Are you okay? What?
Let's go home.
Let's go.
Rover! Lawrence, help! Rover fainted!
Rover!
Lawrence! Rover!
Cousin!
Rover!
Rover! Rover!
Rover!
I've already explained the manifestations of his illness before. Difficulty in breathing, fatigue. At this point, we will also be giving him supplements to help him maintain whatever strength and energy that his body has left. He will also experience a lot of pain, so he will need pain relievers from here on. In addition to that, he will need constant care. So if I may suggest, you might want to think of getting a professional nurse who will take care of him. The days that lie ahead will definitely not be easy ones for Romer. And for your family.
There's no need for a nurse. I will take care of him.
The both of us.
But it won't be easy. He will need constant care 24 hours a day. There will also come a time he might not be able to eat on his own, to stand.
I can handle it, Aunt Margaret. I've already prepared myself for this moment.
Are you sure about this, Shallow? Are you really sure? And you?
Orlando.
Why did you make that statement just now? You know that's not true. Camila, you know what really happened. It was your guards that shot Joaquin, and that's the truth.
I hope you understand why I needed to say all those terrible things about Joaquin. He was shot by my guards, and my reputation would be ruined if I told them that I did know him.
Camilo, reputation?
Not just that. I'm also worried about your safety and Kara's. If Frida discovers the truth, she might even harm Kara. Please forgive me. I promise you, Orlando, I'll give Joaquin a decent burial. And I'll get Kara back for you. My guards are looking for her now.
I'll take care of the details for Joaquin's burial. Promise me one thing, Camilo. Nobody else will be harmed anymore. This ends here. Enough.
Wow. My girlfriend's really something else, huh? And to think you're not even a doctor. Doc, after every injection, you think I can ask for a price? Like a kiss? So, you'll be shifting schedules and taking care of me. I'm really so lucky.
Baby, you really should thank these two. If it weren't for Lawrence and Shallow, your father and I wouldn't know what to do.
But Aunt Margaret and I will cover the first shift now, okay? It'll be better for you two to get some rest.
Okay, we'll drop by later to replace you. Good night, Romer.
See you, Romer. Good night, Uncle. Good
night. Okay, good night.
Okay, bye.
You okay?
Thank you for coming.
Did you get a biscuit? Thank you.
Kara. Kara.
Thank you for the drinks.
Kara. Thank you for still treating my brother like a human being. Even if he was called a criminal on television. Kara, please forgive me. You know I didn't like how things turned out. Orlando, can't you at least show some respect for my brother? How dare you lie to me even here at my brother's wake? Kara.
Kara.
What do you think you're doing here? I want you out of here. Camilo, you are the reason why my brother is already dead. I want you both out of here.
Kara, Kara, please listen to me. Kara, I beg of you, please.
I don't need any of your explanations. Leave me alone. You're the reason why my brother is dead. Just get out of here.
Kara. Kara, please listen to me, Kara.
Don't you even dare pretend to mourn for my brother, because I know that's not true. So just get out of here, the both of you.
Kara.
Get out.
Kara, Kara.
Just get out.
Let the child go, Orlando.
You know, I'm still half wishing that my cousin will get better. Even if it seems impossible. It's nice that you're here. You're taking care of him. You're watching over him. He's very lucky to have you, Shelo.
No. I'm the one who's lucky to have him. In the short time that I've gotten to know him, he's given me so much love, more than I ever imagined. A love that is unconditional. A love that will last forever. He's the only one who made me feel that kind of love.
Shelo. For all it's worth, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything that's happened between us. But I want you to know that I also truly loved you. I never gave up. I also tried to fight for our love.
There's no use forcing the child if she really doesn't want to, Orlando.
What are you doing here?
I adopted Kara. I'm mourning her loss.
You're of no relation to Kara, and you don't care about her.
I took care of her. I fed her. I sent her to school. I treated her like my own flesh and blood. That's why you are wrong, Orlando. I really do care about Kara.
Get out of here, Frida. Leave us alone. You have no right being here, so just leave.
I have more of a right than you. Let's see. Weren't you the one who used her? You used her to get your revenge on me. What kind of a person are you? Huh? You even use children who don't know any better. At admit it. You even had her brother murdered.
I did nothing wrong, Frida. What happened was an accident.
You were the one who brought them here, right? They got tangled up in all of this because of you.
That's not true. I love them both.
Until now, you're nothing but a liar, Orlando. You really don't give a damn about anyone else but yourself.
That's enough! Just stop with all this bickering. Show some respect for my brother.
Kara. Kara, please don't push me away. I loved you. I loved your brother, Joaquin. I'll tell you over and over that it was just an accident. Everything that happened was just an accident, Kara.
Just stop it, please. There's nothing else you can do. My brother's already dead. Sometimes I think to myself that I never should have asked for your help. I wish that you didn't adopt us. My brother would still be alive today. There's nothing more I can say or do because my brother's already dead.
Kara.
Please just stop. Don't add to the pain that I'm already feeling right now. I beg you. Please just stop. I just want you to leave. I just want you to leave. Leave me alone.
Kara, dear. My condolences.
I don't want to hear it.
Shiloh, if you got hurt, I was hurt too. We both got hurt.
Lawrence, I don't want to talk about that. It's in the past now. This isn't the right place, and especially not the right time. We're both here for Romer. Whatever problems you and I had before, and whatever it was that happened between us, it's not important now. I'll go ahead.
I know what you're going through. Must be very difficult. But I'm also partly to blame. I should have never made you leave the mansion. If only I had known. I would have also adopted your brother and let him live with us. We could have avoided all this.
Stop pretending you're all the same. It would be better if you just leave too.
I understand you, my child. I know that you're angry now. But I want you to know, I'm here for you. From now on, my dear, you won't be alone. I won't let them harm you. I'll come back.
My condolences, Kara.
Stop it. I don't need your sympathy, Gian. So you better leave as well.
Understand what she's going through now. She will still be able to forgive you. Not now or tomorrow. But Orlando, I assure you that that time will definitely come.
But I'm afraid, Camilo. Frida can. She can easily brainwash the child. She'll take advantage of the situation. Camilo, she'll surely gain Kara's trust.
No, Orlando. I'll make sure that won't happen. We will not abandon Kara.
Thank you. You know, I'm like a baby now, right? You have to spoon feed me just so I can eat. Mother. Mother. Father. Guys, we already accepted all this, right?
Son, we've accepted it because there's nothing else we can do. How I wish it were me instead of you.
Son, I know that we should have spent more time with you, especially during the times when you needed us most. But God knows we would exchange anything and everything just to have more time with you.
There's no need to, Mother. I'm already very happy that you gave you to me as my parent.
We love you so much, Romer. We love you so much.
Hey, we love you, son.
I love you so much, too.
Thank you, Aunt.
Thank you? Why? You don't need to thank me for anything, Jian. I should be the one apologizing to you. I should have just listened to what you were saying before. But don't worry. We'll find a way to help Kara. But maybe now's not the best time to do anything because she's still mourning and she's not ready to listen. But we'll give her some time. I'm sure she'll come home to us. We're her family.
Thank you again, Aunt.
Go on. Get some rest, huh?
Okay, Aunt. Good night.
Good night.
You're good. You're very, very good. You know, Frida, you never fail to amaze me. A while ago, you were really, really angry at them. And now, you're their friend.
You know what, Ernesto? I care about those kids. And I don't care if you believe it or not.
You know, somehow I find that hard to believe. You don't fool me, Frida. Because I know that you only sympathize with other people as long as you can use them.
You know, I really don't care what you think you know, Ernesto. Truth is, I feel sorry for Kara, and I just want her to come home.
Oh, you want Kara to come home? Why? You want Kara to come home because you want to use her to get back at Orlando.
Perhaps. But you know what? Also, because I want to know something about her. You know, Ernesto, I also know that Kara was close to Orlando before. She even calls Orlando her mother. But you know what? What I don't know is how she and her brother are connected to Orlando and Camilo. That's what I want to put my finger on. Now, you tell me, Ernesto. Are you not in the least bit curious as to what Kara knows? I thought so. So, if I were you, just let me be, okay?
I don't get it. I did everything for Kara.
Hmm.
Truth is, I should be the one getting angry at her. Because she didn't only lie to Aunt Frida, but to me too.
Mm-hmm.
But what did I do? I understood her. I just wish Aunt Frida's words would come true. That she'll forgive me.
Hmm.
I wish she'd come back home.
And then when evening comes, I would insist that I sleep here by the beach. Father and I will bring out the sleeping bags. There'd be a bonfire at the middle. And then I'll fall asleep looking at the stars. The waves will sing a lullaby for me. And I think to myself, wow, this is... it's a great life. And I'm sure everything's going to be okay. You know, Shella, I really want to share that moment with you. I want you to feel how it's like to be at peace. Even if you have a lot of problems, even if your heart feels so heavy, you'd still be able to smile. That's what I really want you to have. I love you. Come on, smile for me.
Romer?
Hey, Lawrence.
Excuse me, guys. Sorry for butting in. Don't get mad.
It's okay.
It's time to take your medication.
Oh, really?
Yes, your mother asked me to remind you.
Okay.
Lawrence, let me do it.
Huh?
It's
no,
okay.
Let me.
Let
it's
me.
Okay, Shadow.
It's okay.
I'll do it.
Oh,
it's okay. Sorry.
I'll do it, sorry.
It's okay, Lawrence. I shall have juice here. It's nothing.
The glass slipped.
Just leave it here.
Here.
Come on, drink your medicine.
Thank you.
All of it, okay?
Okay.
Here.
There.
Wow. I'm so lucky. I can't believe that you're all taking care of me. What will happen if I'm already gone? You've no one to tend to anymore. You know, Lawrence, Shallow, I want you to promise me something. When I'm gone, promise you'll take care of each other?
Come on, Romer. Didn't we talk about this already? That as long as we're here, as much as possible, we won't talk about things like that. Right?
Okay.
And one more thing. Right now, there's no one else I want to take care of but you.
Right. Yes, ma'am.
All right, I'll go inside now. I think I've disturbed you both enough.
Okay, Lawrence.
If you need anything else,
okay.
I'm right here, huh?
Okay, thanks.
Excuse me.
Okay.
Time to eat.
Wow,
here.
That looks really good.
Kara. You don't know how hurt I am with what's been happening. Kara, I never wanted this. I know that you know how much I really love you and your brother. I treated you like you were my own. Not even once did I wish you or your brother any pain or sorrow. Kara. You and I both love Joaquin. If only I could give up my life just so I could bring back your brother's life, I would do it without any hesitation. Forgive me. Forgive me.
Margaret.
Do you remember that summer? I think Romer was about 12 years old. We told him then that we'd spend our summer in America.
Yes. Do you think I could ever forget that? I mean, I almost died of a heart attack because he suddenly went missing. He ran away and came back here alone.
And we ended up spending the summer here. Your son has always been independent. He likes handling things alone. Even his sickness. Arnaldo, I don't know if I can handle seeing him like this.
Margaret.
He's my only son. I can't take this.
Margaret. We have to be strong for our son.
I know.
For his sake. I mean, look at him. He tries to accept the situation that he's in. I'm sure that's what he wants for both of us to do. Go on, stop crying.
But it's too late, Orlando. Nothing you do can bring back the past. My brother is already dead. I hope I can give you back even half of the love that you've given me.
Shallow.
Romer, I'm here beside you.
Shh. I love you.
I know.
When I'm gone, promise you'll take care of each other.
Looks like you've been asking for cash advances more frequently. Is there a problem?
It's my sister. Never mind. It's nothing. I can handle it. I'll take care of it.
Maybe you've already forgotten what you were asked to look after, Derek.
Shella? Oh, I know where she is. She's with Romer and Lawrence on a vacation. We shouldn't worry about anything. Mm-hmm. Because I think that those two will never get back together again.
Hmm?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'll take your word for it.
And besides, I'd know if there's a problem. Alois. Thanks for this.
Okay, no problem.
Okay.
Okay.
Shiloh, I can watch over Romer for you. You can go and get some rest.
No, I'm okay. I can still manage.
I know that you haven't slept for how many nights now. I can watch over him. I don't mind.
No, Lawrence, I'm really okay. You go and rest.
Shiloh, please let me help you out.
Shiloh.
Romer.
Romer?
Romer.
Shiloh. Cello.
Romer?
I can't breathe.
Romer?
Romer? Romer? Romer. Lawrence, hurry. Romer?
No.
Lawrence, what are you doing?
I don't
give
know.
That to me.
Romer.
Romer, you'll be okay.
Romer.
You'll be okay,
I'll go
Romer.
Get Aunt.
Romer, stay with me, please. You'll be okay, Romer. Romer?
How is my son, Doc?
Well, right now, he's no longer in pain. But I regret to tell you, Mrs. Ledesma, that his condition is getting worse. Romer can go any time now. I don't want to make you lose hope. But with his situation now, it's possible he'll never wake up.
Rosie,
mm-hmm.
Put that in the car, and then after you do that, call Gian. We're leaving already, all right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Where are you going?
To Kara. I'm going to bring her clothes and some food.
You're really going to pursue this?
You know, she's going through a hard time, and we are her only family. I think that I'm doing the right thing, don't you think?
Oh, yes. For once, what you're going to do is right. You just have the wrong intentions.
Ernesto, you know, I've had enough of your comments. Do you think I've really lost all the sincerity that I have? Look, if Kara does know something that she wants to share with us, that's up to her. May I remind you, Ernesto, I also took care of the child. The reason I sent her away was because I got surprised. It's natural, because it turned out she lied to me. But you know what, Ernesto, right now, the child needs my help. So I really don't care whatever it is you're thinking. I'm going to help her. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have somewhere to go.
Please!
Aunt Margaret. It would be better if you got some rest.
I am not going to leave my son.
But Aunt Margaret...
No! I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying right here with my son, Shiloh.
The truth is... I can't take it anymore. I'm not as strong as your Aunt Margaret, Lawrence. I guess women are really stronger than us men.
Uncle.
No, it's true. The thing with us men, we usually suppress the real emotions that we're feeling inside. We're supposed to act manly. We're not supposed to cry. We always need to be the strong one. But the truth is, we're really just pretending. That's what we're good at, pretending. But look at your Aunt Margaret. Look at Shiloh. Yes, they're crying. But they've already come to accept the reality of your cousin's situation. But me, you know, I just can't bear seeing him lying there helpless. I can't even stand beside your Aunt Margaret to comfort her or to give her a hug.
Uncle.
I'm sorry, Lawrence. It's just so hard.
I'm so sorry, Shiloh. I know that I shouldn't have shouted at you. You've shown our family nothing but kindness. I'm so sorry.
Don't worry, it's all right. I understand, Aunt Margaret.
I'm really scared, Shiloh. There's not a minute that goes by that I don't pray for him, even if I know that I'm just waiting for the time that he's going to leave his father and me. Every night, I'm even afraid to close my eyes, because I might wake up and discover that Romer's no longer with us. That's just too much for a mother to bear, Shiloh. Shiloh, can you please leave us alone for a while? Please, just for a while. I just want to have some time with my son.
Okay, Aunt.
Shiloh.
Lawrence. Him. He's such a kind person. Of all people, why'd it have to be him?